Order. Our first order of business this morning is that we are very fortunate to have a presentation that Dr. Richard Carvajal and Mr. Scott Purvis, they're going to deliver for us on the One Valdosta Lounge effort. So gentlemen, if you would, please come forward and thank you for coming.
Well, good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Scott.
Richard and I are excited to be here. As you know, we have been working on the One Valdosta Lounge initiative for several years now. COVID did get in our way, but we're excited to be here. We want to make this presentation to you. We're so close to the finish line of getting this thing completed. We want to knock this thing out and begin doing some major celebrations. So with that, I'm going to kind of go over how we started, how we got involved with One Valdosta Lounge, and where we are today. And then Richard's going to come up and talk about some actual details in the plan. But any community, no matter how great it is, has room for growth. And in Valdosta Lounge County is no different. We've got a lot of good things going, but there's always ways we can improve. And at the time, Jason Manley was our region VP for Georgia Power here. And when he would go to meetings with his peers, other regional VPs, he would ask them, what is your community's doing to improve themselves, to make themselves better? And in each instance, they told him their community had either done a community-wide strategic plan or they were going through a community-wide strategic plan. So that's where this idea came about, where it originated. Now, it might have originated with Georgia Power, but this is not a Georgia Power initiative. It is a community initiative. So from there, we had the idea, and the first thing we did was we knew we had to have the right players on board. So the first two players we met with, City of Valdosta, Lowndes County Board of Commissioners, to say, okay, this is what we're thinking about doing. This is a strategic plan we want to unfold, but if you guys are not on board, it's not going to go anywhere. So after discussions, the city and the county said, we're in. And after that, our next group that we went to was the Chamber of Commerce and the Development Board. Same thing. We're doing the strategic plan. You're integral parts of the community. Want to make sure you're on board, because it's not going to work if you're not on board. They also agreed. So we had the what we call the big four on board: the city, the county, the chamber, and the development authority. And from there, we added South Georgia Medical Center and Valdosta State because of their strong community presence, but also because of their strong regional presence. We started this basically in the summer of 2017, we sent out RFIs. We got some of those back, and we interviewed three consulting groups: Matt Holliday with Market Street Services, Jay Garner with Garner and Associates, and Vision First, Grace Sloot. And the steering committee that was formed voted to go with Vision First. And so they were the ones who came in and were helping us. The whole point of this One Valdosta Lounge, as we worked with our consultant, was to stress that we want to spur economic growth in our community and become the economic capital of South Georgia. So with that, working with Vision First, we started in the spring of 18, and they did personal interviews, they did one-on-one interviews, we had a website to go to and take interviews. We also did facilitated sessions with the steering committee, and Vision First began presenting us with some deliverables, demographic information, and the basis for what would be a draft plan. But they came back to us, and they said there's five things that we are hearing on a pretty consistent basis from these interviews and people we're talking with. And those five things were that the community is divided, and there seems to be a lack of trust. Some of it's reality, some of it is perception. There are great things going on in the community, but everyone is working in their own silo, and there's not a lot of communication. The second thing they told us was there was not a unified vision, and this goes back to working in silos, is that there's a lot of good things happening, but the community really has not decided the direction it's going in, or what they wanted to be when it grew up. Economic development is not well understood. The community understands that front page ribbon cutting when there's a new location such as Arglass. But what they had trouble understanding is how business retention, downtown development, tourism, entrepreneurship, and even retail and commercial were all a part of that economic development portfolio. They told us we had some great existing assets, and the two that were really brought out in these surveys was Wiregrass Technical College and Valdosta State University. And then finally, there was a belief in these interviews that they kept getting, is that people believe that Valdosta Lowndes County could be the regional leader of South Georgia. And it's more than just location, and it's more than just size. This is a conscious effort to become that leader. So working through that, our goal was to finish and work and launch One Valdosta Lowndes in the spring of 20. But we worked with Vision First, and we identified some co-chairs, take ownership of some of the committees of this plan, which would be vision, engagement, talent, place, and opportunity. Vision would be taken on by the steering committee to have an agreed upon destination. Engagement, citizens and community leaders both engaged in the decision making in the community. Talent is aligning education and training to inspire workforce. Place is, of course, to build a vibrant community through quality of life placemaking, investing in the current citizens who already live here. And then finally, opportunity to provide a wide array of jobs that allow upward mobility and a good quality of life. And as I said, we were hoping to launch this in the spring of 20. We had a meeting on January 17th, in 2020, and we had a very unfortunate incident during that meeting. And we were not able to finish. We had to stop the meeting. And so we had another meeting planned for March 20th. Well, as you know, the world shut down March 15th. So we were not able to have that meeting. So COVID did give us a little setback. And we were losing a little momentum. So Richard and I got together and said, how can we keep this thing going in COVID? Because we don't know what COVID is going to bring when we're all going to be back. So we took a step back and decided to assess the work that we'd already done. Because we started in 2017. We were already in 2020, so in essence, had already worked on this in 3 years. So we wanted to look at what has changed and what was maybe going to change because of COVID. And we started doing some one-on-one interviews, and we really engaged the private sector business community. We did one-on-one interviews, Richard and I did small group interviews, and then finally that July, we did a large group interview. And they gave us some great feedback on the plan, and first and foremost, there was a consensus that they liked what we were doing and they liked that we were trying to do a strategic plan for the community. Many said that we've not done this in a while. Many said that this needed to be done, so they felt we were on the right track. One of the surprise from the business community is they were not really as much focused on the job growth components of the plan, but they really honed in on our quality of life placemaking, and I'll get to probably why they did that in just a second. They wanted to see more cooperation among agencies. That's not just City County, but that's all agencies in our community. They wanted to see more public-private partnerships. And the one thing they did not like about the plan was our vision statement. They felt it was too wordy and that citizens would not be able to understand it. So with that, Richard and I took that information. We called another steering committee meeting. And Vision First had completed what they said they were going to do with us. They filled their 18-month contract. They had delivered the demographic information we'd asked for, and they had delivered us a draft plan. So with that, we asked the steering committee of how we were going to move forward, because in talking with the business community, they picked out some things that maybe had not been covered. We had a good plan, but there were some ways we felt that we could make this good plan even better. And so with the unanimous vote of the steering committee, they voted to allow Richard and myself to take what Vision First had done in a draft plan and add an addendum to it. In other words, looking for things like how could we change the vision statement, looking for a home to place one of Valdosta Lounge, and finally looking at maybe some big wins or some big projects that the community could get behind, support, and rally behind. Because as the current plan was written, it was written for a lot of quick wins. So, and then finally, our focus is on economic development. It is the primary goal, and it means retaining and recruiting talent. Economic development has changed somewhat over the last couple of decades. Industrial parks, available buildings, and workforce are always going to be your key components, but it's that workforce that's really trained. Companies are looking for a skilled workforce, and a workforce that's not only skilled but can be retrained. So it's now really about talent. And that is where it's really changed. When you and I see most of us in here, we're probably not all millennials. But when we graduated high school, or we got out of the military, or we graduated college, the first thing we did was picked up a newspaper and went to the one ads to look for a job. We found that job, we moved to that community, and that's where we set up shop to build our career and build our lives. For Generation X and the millennials and Generation Z do not do that. They look to see where they want to live first and then find a job. Now, to me, that's a recipe for starvation, but it's a different generation, and that is the way they do it. And so that is why we really focused in on a lot of quality of life issues and a lot of placemaking issues, because it's really twofold. It is about attracting and attaining that talent, because companies now are not just moving to where there's product, but they are moving to where there is a talent pool. And its second part of that is, it's also investing in the citizens that are already living in our community, retaining them in a place where young people can come back to. We already have two great assets here that attract young people in Wiregrass and Valdosta State, and how can we capture those folks to live here? So that's why in the OVL community and economic development, is that plan is very focused on that quality of life and placemaking issue. So with that, I'm going to turn it over to Richard for further discussion.